This is our biosphere, and this is the story of its creation. This is Earth. It is governed by the sun and the moon. Their role is to influence all of the elements present on Earth. For example, tides are caused by the moon, while without the sun, life would not possibly exist. In the beginning, the oceans and the atmosphere were formed by volcanoes erupting at the Earth's surface and the ground moving below. Volcanoes had an even more important role after that. They supplied the planet with natural gases and other vital ingredients, in other words, the right conditions for the creation of life. If we looked at the sky, at the dawn of creation, we could see the collision of comets and asteroids that brought water to the Earth's surface. Our planet lies in what is known as the Goldilocks zone, a region surrounding a star that is close enough for liquid water to exist on our planet's surface, with water neither freezing nor evaporating. Many scientists think that being in this zone and the presence of liquid water plays a key role in the existence of life. Talking about life, did you know that plants made a leap onto land around 450 million years ago? They converted carbon dioxide from the atmosphere into oxygen at a rapid rate, which led to the first ice age. As a result, global temperatures plummeted, initiating widespread glaciations due to the shock caused by low temperatures. Earth's rocks broke down into smaller and smaller pieces, and that's how soils started to form. After some time, rainwater dissolved the rock elements, while temperature fluctuations caused cracks in the rocks. This continuous process of water freezing and ice melting inside these gaps eventually cracked the rocks into smaller pieces. While the soil was forming, plants continued to spread their roots in order to stabilize and shape the landscape we see today. This is how rivers were formed from the initial broad sheets of water, trees began to grow, and our planet transformed into a flourishing ecosystem. Right now, we are living the stories of our present and paving the roads to our future. Knowing how all those small changes allowed us to live on this beautiful planet, do you think we can make better choices for the world we are creating? Let me know in the comments what small actions you take for the future you wish to see.